السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على خير خلق الله وعلى آله وصحابه ومن استنى بسنته إلى يوم الدين. Welcome back to our series The Ailment and the Cure based on the book الداء والدواء by the great scholar Ibn al-Qayyim, may Allah have mercy on him. After the author spoke about the harmful and evil effects that sins may have on a person's life in this world and in the next, the author, he reminds us that it doesn't stop there, but rather he reminds us of the importance of enjoining good or commanding that which is good and forbidding what is evil. And he reminds us through using a number of narrations of the Prophet ﷺ and companions and some of the righteous scholars. And from the things that the author, he mentions, a hadith that is related to us by the companion Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, part of a longer hadith, but just I'll read the end of it, that Ibn Abbas, he said that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, وَمَا تَرَكَ قَوْمٌ الْأَمْرَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَالنَّهْيَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ, that basically there is never a time that a group of people or a nation that they stop commanding what is good or they abandon enjoining what is good and forbidding what is evil, إِلَّا لَمْ تُرْفَعْ أَعْمَالُهُمْ, except that their actions will then not be raised, meaning their righteous actions won't be raised to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَمْ يُسْمَعْ دُعَاؤُهُمْ, and their supplications will not be heard, meaning they will not be responded to. So it's not sufficient that we ourselves don't engage in evil actions or in sins, but we remind ourselves that we have to have a positive effect on the community that is around us, the people that are around us, our family members, our community members, and society at large. Being people that enjoin good and forbid evil, this concept that we are commanded by within the Quran and reminded numerous times again and again, that one of the reasons or one of the things that makes us the best of generations or the best of ummah is that we should have this quality of being people that enjoin the good and forbid the evil. We also find a hadith related by Aisha radiallahu anha, that she mentions that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam one day ascended the minbar, and he فَحَمِدَ اللَّهُ وَأَثْنَى عَلَيْهِ, that he praised and thanked Allah, and then he said, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ, O people, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَقُولُ لَكُمْ, indeed Allah is saying to all of you, or has said to all of you, مُرُوا بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَانْهَوْ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ, enjoin what is good, command what is good, and forbid what is evil. قَبْلَ أَن تَدْعُونِي فَلَا أُجِيبُكُمْ, or if you don't, then perhaps it will reach a state where you will supplicate to me for your needs, for the things that you want, فَلَا أُجِيبُكُمْ, and I will not respond to you. Now remember, these are not people that are indulging in sin, or what is preventing these people's du'as from being accepted is not that they themselves were indulging in sin, but they were seeing other people commit acts of immorality and sins and offenses against Allah, and they said nothing. They turned a blind eye to it. So قَبْلَ أَن تَدْعُونِي فَلَا أُجِيبُكُمْ, that before it ends up in a situation where you're supplicating to me and I don't respond to you. وَتَسْتَنْصِرُونِي فَلَا أَنْصُرُكُمْ, and you're seeking help from me and I don't assist you. وَتَسْأَلُونِي فَلَا أُعْطِيكُمْ, and you're asking of me and I won't give you. Also, one of the scholars of the past, Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah, he mentions, he said that إِنَّ مِنْ غَفْلَتِكَ عَنْ نَفْسِكَ, that from amongst the signs that you are heedless about your own self, وَإِعْرَاضِكَ عَنِ اللَّهِ, and a sign that you are slowly beginning to turn away from Allah, is أَنْ تَرَى مَا يُسْخِطُ اللَّهَ فَتَتَجَاوَزَهُ, is that you yourself see those things around you that which bring about the anger and the wrath of Allah, فَتَتَجَاوَزَهُ, and you just pass them by. They don't bother you, you don't enjoin any good, you don't command in those situations, you don't forbid any evil. خَوْفًا مِمَّنْ لَا يَمْلِكُ لِنَفْسِهِ ضُرًّا وَلَا نَفْعًا. Why does perhaps a person not say anything? Why does a person, when they see wrong, remain silent? Or why do they not advise one another with that which is good or enjoin with that which is good? He says, خَوْفًا, out of fear. Many times it's out of fear. What will that person think of me? What will the perception of the community be about me if I stand up against injustice or call out a wrong for being wrong? But the scholar, he said, خَوْفًا مِمَّنْ لَا يَمْلِكُ لِنَفْسِهِ ضُرًّا وَلَا نَفْعًا. This person that is not engaging in الْأَمْرُ بِالْمَعْرُوفُ وَالنَّهِي عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ, that perhaps they are doing so out of fear. And they fear someone, a being, a created being, that created being, they don't possess even for themselves the ability to benefit themselves or to harm themselves, let alone harming and benefiting others, even for themselves. This person that has abandoned enjoining good and forbidding evil, they're afraid of that person that doesn't even possess harm and benefit for their own self. One scholar, he also said, مَنْ تَرَكَ الْأَمْرَ بِالْمَعْرُوفُ وَالنَّهِي عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ, that whomsoever abandons enjoining what is good and forbidding what is evil, مَخَافَةً مِنَ الْمَخْلُوقِينَ, out of fear of the creation, out of fear of other human beings, نُزِعَتْ مِنْهُ الطَّاعَةِ, that it is possible that perhaps what might end up happening to that individual that is not necessarily engaging in sin, not necessarily even directly condoning immoral behavior or evil acts, but is not engaging in this concept of enjoining what is good and forbidding what is evil, that perhaps نُزِعَتْ مِنْهُ الطَّاعَةِ, that the obedience, the righteous actions of this person, himself or herself, will slowly be stripped away from that person. That person, they will begin to lose their own righteousness. Now, without a doubt, enjoining good and forbidding evil, it should be done in a proper manner, in proper situation, proper circumstance and conditions, with care and love. The people that you are advising to do good or you are forbidding from evil, they have to feel, they have to know that you care for them, that you love them, that you want what's best for them. It has to be done with gentleness and softness, right? Perhaps first getting to know the person, getting acquainted with the person, who they are, what their name is, what their background is, where they're coming from, what their experiences are, and then trying to have a positive effect on them, as opposed to just commanding and forbidding people left and right, scaring people, giving people the perception that you are harsh or mean or you don't care about them. But rather it should be the opposite. Show people that you care for them, you love them, you want what's best for them. And once they feel that, once they realize that, then advising them to do that which is good, commanding the good and forbidding the evil. Also is mentioned that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, إِنَّ النَّاسَ إِذَا رَأُوا الظَّالِمُ فَلَمْ يَأْخُذُوا عَلَى يَدِهِ, that if the people, they see someone that is committing wrong, or even someone that is committing injustice and oppression, and they don't hold that person accountable, especially when it's a person that's committing oppression and injustice, and they don't hold that person accountable, أَوْشَكَ أَنْ يَعُمَّهُمُ اللَّهُ بِعِقَابٍ مِنْ عِنْدِهِ, it's possible that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will cover all of those people with his punishment. It's mentioned that Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu anhu, he once said, تُوشِكُ الْقُرَىٰ أَن تُخَرِّبَ وَهِيَ عَامِرَةٌ, that it is very likely that the villages and the towns are going to be destroyed while currently they are flourishing. So he was asked, كَيْفَ تُخَرِّبُ وَهِيَ عَامِرَةٌ, كَيْفَ تُخَرَّبُ وَهِيَ عَامِرَةٌ, that how can they be destroyed while they are flourishing? So he says, إِذَا عَلَى فُجَّارُهَا أَبْرَارَهَا, that when the evil and the wicked people in these societies, in these towns, they overpower and they dominate over the righteous. Meaning that this is what will happen if people don't enjoin good, command what is good and forbid what is evil, that eventually evil and sin and immorality, it will become widespread and prevalent throughout society, wherever we will look, in front of us, behind us, left and right. And he says, إِذَا عَلَى فُجَّارُهَا أَبْرَارَهَا, that what it will eventually lead to is that the wicked people, the evil people, will outnumber and dominate and overpower over the righteous people. And when this happens, he says, then the towns and the villages, they will experience difficulty and trials and tribulations and punishments from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ibn Abbas radiyallahu anhu, he also narrates, attributing to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that the Messenger of Allah said, يأتي زمان يذوب فيه قلب المؤمن كما يذوب الملح في الماء, that there will come a time where the heart of the believer will like melt away or will dissolve, meaning that their iman will continue to decrease and decrease day by day, literally second by second. كَمَا يَذُوبُ الْمِلْحُ فِي الْمَاءِ just like salt dissolves in water. So he was asked, مِمَّ ذَاكَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ, what will cause this to occur? What will cause the heart of the believer to dissolve like this? So the Messenger of Allah said, مِمَّا يَرَى مِنَ الْمُنْكَرِ لَا يَسْتَطِيعُ تَغْيِيرَهُ, because of what the believer sees of evil and wickedness and sins around him. لَا يَسْتَطِيعُ تَغْيِيرَهُ, and now he doesn't have any ability or any power to bring about change, to bring about any positive change. Also, one of the companions he narrates, and we'll end with this, that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, مَا مِنْ قَوْمٍ يُعْمَلُ فِيهِمْ بِالْمَعَاصِي, that there's no group of people, that there's no nation in which sins are being committed. وَهُمْ أَعَزُّ وَأَكْثَرُ مِمَّنْ يَعْمَلُهُ, and the people that are not indulging in sin are more powerful and more abundant and more numerous than the ones that are committing sins. So never is there a time that there is a nation or a group of people in which sins are being committed, but the ones not committing sins are more powerful and more numerous and more abundant. فَلَمْ يُغَيِّرُهُ, but those people, the righteous people, the people of Iman and faith, they don't bring about any change. They don't have a positive effect or influence on society. إِلَّا عَمَّهُمُ اللَّهُ بِعِقَابٍ, except that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make His punishment prevail over all of them, will send down punishment upon all of the people. The author, rahimahullah, reminding us through these narrations that not only do we have an obligation to protect ourselves and to prevent ourselves from falling into sins because of the harm that it will bring us in this world and in the next, and it will bring about the displeasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but also we have an obligation to be people that have a positive impact and influence on the people around us and its society at large by enjoining what is good and forbidding what is evil. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us amongst people that have those qualities. Jazakum Allah khairan for joining me. Wa sallallahu ala nabina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.